Do you ever open up a rocket kit and find that the coupler is inside the tube and you just can't get it out? I'm going to show you how to do that in this video.
Welcome to Advanced Construction Videos, where we show you how to tackle rocketry, building techniques, and more. On our website, we sell kits, motors, building supplies, and electronics. So come and learn, shop, build, and fly when you visit us at ApogeeRockets.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Van Milligan from Apogee Components. Today I'm going to cover how to get that coupler out of the tube. Now, a lot of manufacturers ship the couplers inside the tube because it saves space, which saves a lot of money in shipping costs. But a lot of times those couplers can get stuck in the tubes, and then customers, they call us asking us advice on how to get them out. Well, today I'm going to show you my technique. I'm using a clear tube here so that you can see what's going on. But what happens is the coupler, there's a little bit of slack in the coupler in the tube. And so the coupler may not be perfectly straight in the tube. It may be just slightly canted. And what happens if you try to push on an edge with a coupler like this, you could actually force it to be canted even more in the tube, and that makes the problem worse. So you don't want to put in a dowel and start pushing on the edge, because that's going to make it worse. What you have to do is push on both edges at the same time. So for an example, here I have a 29 millimeter tube with a 29 millimeter coupler, and if I put this in there, if you can't reach it with your finger, what you can do is you can stick a rocket motor in there and just slide it out, because that pushes evenly on both sides of the coupler. But the real trick, and what I tell people all the time, is you have to twist the coupler. Because what that does is when you twist it, it realigns the coupler in the tube so that you can then pull it out. Now this coupler is in pretty deep. Let's see, this is going to be not deep enough. I do have a tool for that. But it gets a lot worse when the rocket tube is bigger, because the tolerances are tighter. So here I have a 4-inch diameter tube and I have a coupler in there. And this one is in there pretty good, and I can't get enough leverage by grabbing it or by sticking. What I'm doing is sticking my fist in there and trying to wedge my fist in there so I can try to spin it, but I don't have enough leverage. So there is a trick to doing this. And what it involves is taking a paint stir stick or any flat stick like this. These are cheap. And what we need to do is to cut this so that it just fits inside the coupler. So here I've gone ahead and I've found a piece that I've already cut, and this slides into the tube and into the coupler, and it's a little bit loose, but I'd like it a little bit tighter, but that's going to be okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to glue this into the coupler temporarily. We're going to take it out later. And then that's going to give us some leverage that we can use to twist. So for this, I like to use thick super glue because I don't want to get any glue on the tube itself, only in the coupler. So I'm going to put a bead of glue on each side. And then when you put this into the coupler, you want to kind of, if you can, squeeze it so you're making the tube an oblong shape like this. That way there's more room so that you can slide this in without getting it on the inside of the tube, because you just want to get it into the coupler. So I'm going to get it into my coupler like that. And I'm actually pressing down a little bit just to make sure that it holds in place. And I'm going to give it a little fillet of glue. I don't know if you can see this. This side's not in perfectly straight. Just like that. And then I'm going to take the InstaSet. And what this does is it accelerates the cure on the super glue so that it will kick off really fast. And I want to let this sit for about a minute or so. If you have a small tube like this, you can use a popsicle stir stick, either something like this. So this one I've already cut off. And again, I've made a short piece. And then if you have a long pair of pliers or something like that, you can use that to grab and stick it into the tube. But I unfortunately pushed this one in a little bit too far. Now this one is a little snug, so I would have to sand that down using a sanding tee so that it just goes inside the coupler. And then same thing, I want to glue it in the coupler, and when that's in the tube, I can get into that stir stick and then twist, and that's what you want to do is twist and then pull it out. Okay, so now this one has been sitting there for a second or two. Let's see if I can grab it and twist it. Yes, I can. See, now I got some leverage on it and I can pull it out. And then when it's out, then I can snap this off. And then just take some sandpaper or a needle file and then sand off any of that glue inside. The glue is not going to hurt anything on the inside because most of the time the coupler is used to join two tubes together and you're not looking at the coupler. So it's just a cosmetic blemish at this point, having that glue on the inside. It doesn't ruin the coupler at all. So that is the trick on getting couplers out of the tube. Again, the trick is twist the coupler. Don't push on it on one edge unless you can push on it with both edges at the same time, like with using a rocket motor. So my name is Tim Van Milligan. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. And also subscribe to our newsletter. Every week we put out a new video or a newsletter that has a lot of great information that will help you, tips like these that will help you do rocketry better, faster, and cheaper. So may the winds be light, may the skies be blue, and may all your rockets fly straight and true.